Greeting, brothers and sisters in Christ. Pastor Mike here. This is our online service for Reformation Sunday, October 25th. It was great to have vacation. Thank you for Gary for filling in. Hopefully you all enjoyed his message last Sunday. As I mentioned, today is Reformation Sunday, one of the holidays for the Lutheran Church where we celebrate the work of the Reformers and the work of the Spirit through them. But also for everyone, a blessed Halloween. Hopefully in some way, shape, or form, you are able to enjoy or go with your littles to enjoy the holiday. But also a blessed All Saints on November 1st. And I would encourage you, if there's anyone you wish to have remembered on that Sunday, please get it into Kathy sooner rather than later. Those are just some of the brief announcements that I'm trying to draw your attention to. Now, let's take a brief moment together, hearts and minds, for worship. Now, brothers and sisters in Christ, as we begin worship, we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Now, Jesus said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all of the law and the prophets. Let us speak the truth about ourselves to our neighbors and to God, acknowledging what we have done and what we have left undone." And so together as God's people, we confess. Your holiness, O God, commands that we confess. We have neither loved our neighbors as ourselves, nor honored ourselves as your beloved creation. We have judged unjustly, regarded others ungenerously, profited at the loss of those near and distant, borne grudges, desired vengeance, and kept silence in the face of wrongdoing. We long to live in accord with your desire that your way of compassion, kindness, and honesty will govern our hearts and minds, turning us toward lives of peace. Forgive us and lead us. Amen. Now, brothers and sisters in Christ, the Holy One who promises forgiveness to those who seek the good hears your confession. As the crucified and risen child of God, your Redeemer fully knows your sorrow and your desire for reconciled relationships. You are forgiven. In that promise is the power to love your neighbors and yourselves as beloved of God who created all that exists. Amen. Thanks be to God. Our opening song is Come. Now is the time to worship.
Just as you.
opening dialogue. God makes the sun rise and set. He is faithful from generation to generation. God makes summer and winter come and go. He is faithful from generation to generation. God helps plants grow and flowers bloom. He is faithful from generation to generation. God gives us food to eat, places to live, and people to love us. He is faithful from generation to generation. God is always with us. He is faithful from generation to generation. God keeps his promises to us. He is faithful from generation to generation. Let us praise our faithful God. Now, the Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Gracious Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church. Fill it with all truth and peace. Where it is corrupt, purify it. Where it is in error, direct it. Where in anything it is amiss, reform it. Where it is right, strengthen it. Where it is in need, provide for it. Where it is divided, reunite it. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, both now and forever. Amen. Good morning, my little Lutherans. How you doing? Pastor Mike again, as always. Today is a church day, a Sunday, that we celebrate something special. It's a big word. It's called the Reformation. The Reformation and why we celebrate it is really good because it reminds us of something. I don't know about you, but I can forget things. Maybe you forget homework sometimes. Maybe you forget to do it. Maybe you forget to bring it to school. Maybe you have shoes and you forget where you put them, or your coat. You forget it at school. We all forget, but it's not just stuff. We can forget other things. And this Sunday reminds us of something really important. Even when Pastor is preaching and teaching, we can sometimes, and he can sometimes, lose sight of something called grace. The Reformation is all about reminding us that it's grace that saves us. Grace is the fancy term for the fact that God loves us, not because of what we do, but because of who he is. It's like, I love my kids even when they mess up, because they're my kids. Your parents love you even if you forget numerous things, and even if you forget that they love you, they still do. And that's grace. And that's what today reminds us of. And this, in front of me, are two things that remind me of some things important. Right here is my buddy, Playmobil Martin Luther. And he sits on my desk to always remind me of grace and the work of Reformation. And then this is Lego Pastor, which is to always remind me of my family and how important they are. Because my boys made this for me. And so they, like the Reformation, are there to remind me in case I start to forget. So I always put it someplace important. So today, it's about remembering. All right, well, thanks, little Lutherans. You guys have a great Sunday. Our first reading for this Sunday is from Jeremiah, the 31st chapter. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt. A covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts. And I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, know the Lord. For they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our psalm for this morning is Psalm 46. Please join me in its reading. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth be moved, and though the mountains shake in the depths of the sea,
Though its waters rage in foam, and though the mountains tremble with its tumult, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city, it shall not be shaken. God shall help it at the break of day. The nations rage and the kingdoms shake. God speaks and the earth melts away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come now, regard the works of the Lord, what desolations God has brought upon the earth. Behold, the one who makes war cease to the end in all the world, who breaks the bow and shatters the spear and burns the shields with fire. Be still then and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Our second reading for this morning comes from the third chapter of the book of Romans. Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those under the law, so that every mouth shall be silenced, and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For no human being will be justified in his sight by deeds prescribed by the law, for through the law comes the knowledge of sin. But now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed, and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift, through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes of boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us read the gospel by singing together, Alle, 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 Alleluia. According to St. John, the 8th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Now Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, if you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. They answered him, we are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying you will be made free? Jesus answered them, very truly I tell you, everyone who commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The son has a place there forever. So if the son makes you free, you will be free indeed. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Well, brothers and sisters, today we gather to celebrate something that happened 500 years ago. You've heard me mention it a couple times in worship what this thing is. But to remind you, in Wittenberg, on 1517, on October 31st, that year, Luther nailed his 95 theses to the church door. What it was is a response to the selling of indulgences in that area. These theses laid out an amazing set of theological points that were there to hinder, to stop the sale of these horrible indulgences. And the result was that it hurt the income of the church that day. Now, there was a lot going on in what I just told you in that time. What indulgences were, in many ways, it was paying off the sins that we had committed. A lot had happened to Luther in his theological work
that led him to courageously write these things as well. So much is happening. But all of that reality is summed up in what is often called the Reformation. And it is this historic celebration that we do today. We celebrate this historic reality that has affected the church ever since that moment. But even as we celebrate the historic realities, the pieces of it, as we stand here in 2020, where it was even in 2017, we celebrated the 500th anniversary, we must always pause and ask a question. What is the heart of the Reformation? Even as we celebrate the events that were happening, we also need to ask why. Why did this have to take place? And even as we live now, we have to ask, why should we celebrate it? Is it really that important that we take time in our worship to focus on this? Hasn't so much changed in 500 years, Pastor? Well, I don't know if you ever heard this phrase, but I believe it. The more things change, the more they stay the same. The reality of the Reformation, beyond historic, political, economic realities, is a spiritual one. The struggle of an individual and of many individuals. The struggle is made clearest in the life of Luther, because he struggled with God at that time. He struggled with the reality. He struggled with how God was presented as cruel, uncaring, almost looking for ways to send people to hell. And when he reached a point of distinct honesty with himself, he came to hate God and God's cruelty. He hated that God would sit in that lofty place and judge people in a cruel manner. When asked what he wanted out of God, it was just a God that loved him. Grace. And it was amazing, because when he studied scripture, when he looked into the word itself, he found what he was looking for in God. And that his struggle was the horrible misrepresentation of God, not the truth of who God truly is. And he discovered there that amazing joy that God loves him for who he was. And it changed him. Changed him to such a degree. Changed him in viewing the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, not as anger, not as some guilt trip from God, but as of a loving God who wanted that relationship, who wanted, wouldn't go to any ends to save us and to be with us. And it is a great day, because these texts that we have are so formative to Luther's thought, especially our Romans text. And if you look at it, and I encourage you to do it, you will see some of the pieces. Here, let me read one of my favorite parts. Now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Grace as a gift. And it was that simple phrase that changed Luther. A free gift. And that is ultimately why the Reformation took place. Because the people of that day had forgotten, like I talked about in the children's sermon. They had lost sight. They had become comfortable again with the law, with legalism, and the ability to judge and to try to put people here, there, and that. And it's so easy to put that as a wall between us and the light of truth. And it's amazing, because Luther was not alone in his struggle. Many in that day were weighed down by a God that they viewed as anger, but it was a misrepresentation. They were vexed and flayed by the law and never being good enough, and the indulgences just piled upon it. And when Luther when Luther pushed back, it ignited the hearts and the minds of many to turn again to the love of God, to see that, to see grace again. And that is ultimately why the Reformation took place. Not because of Luther, not because of Scripture, but because the one who is greater than all of them, God, he refuses to let us forget his grace and his love. And so he works through his word, through his broken people, to again shine the light of truth on that. And he will use any means at his disposal to make it true. Even a broken instrument like Luther, even broken instruments like us. So today, that is what we celebrate. The Reformation and the eternal Reformation of God. For God is always reforming, reminding, guiding, binding, healing his church. For the church in every age can forget and lose sight of what the key is, the center, the core of what it means to be Christian. We can get again tempted by law and judgment and the power that those things feel they give us. But that is not the way. We can also be vexed by the law of the world that surrounds us. The perfect life, the perfect home, the perfect car, the perfect clothes. And if we do everything perfect, life will be good. That is law, brothers and sisters in Christ. That is law. That if you buy this, eat this, wear this, smell like this, you will finally be good. That's law. And that is not as God's way. Even the church says when we need to say the right prayers at the right time in the right manner. That is not his way. That is our way. His way is always the way of life and light and peace and grace. And that is what we do today. We again, in the midst of our worries, our struggles, because they're there right now, are they not? I don't need to elucidate them. You could tell me for days on straight what the struggle is right now. But in the midst of that, the light shines of the grace of God, a free gift. And that is what we remember today. And that is my prayer, brothers and sisters in Christ. Remember. Remember that God loves you, period, full stop. Not because of what you do, not because you're perfect, not by any works of the law, but because he created you, he formed you, and he saved you. He loves you. Be reformed. Be remade and renewed in that truth to shine the light of his grace in a world in need. Amen.
Our song of the day is A Mighty Fortress Is Our God.
Salvation, glory.
Now then, let us confess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now, with confidence in God's grace and mercy, let us pray for the Church, the world, and all those in need. We pray for our presiding bishop, Elizabeth Eaton, our NAS bishop, Jeffrey Clements, our missionary, Kristen Engstrom, our companion churches both in Tanzania and in India. Renew and inspire the Church in the freedom of the gospel, O God. Where the Church is an error, reform it. Where the Church speaks your truth, strengthen it. Where the Church is divided, unify it. Ignite in us the working of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As the earth changes, as mountains shake, and the waters roar, may we care for this planet as a holy habitation for all living things. Sustain all peoples and lands recovering from natural disasters of any kind. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Guide areas of the world divided or traumatized by conflict, especially in our own land. Free all from slavery and human trafficking, and protect all in harm's way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Release those who are living in bondage to debts, chronic pain, addiction. Grant healing to all those who are ill, especially those who are affected by COVID-19. Bless those who seek peace and harmony in our world. And give your healing to all those on our prayer chain and those we name aloud in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In this family of faith, we give thanks for courageous voices that have remained firm in their commitment to the one who frees us from sin and death. Send it in your grace, unify us in the hope of the gospel. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Even in death, you free us and give us a place in your house. We give thanks for our ancestors who have shown us truth and freedom, especially Martin Luther, and those who work for the renewal of the Church. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Finally, into your hands, Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always, and also with you. I encourage you to share that peace throughout the week, and especially those who you are gathered with today. For offering, as always, I give thanks for your continuing support wherever you are for the mission ministry of the Church at large, but especially here at Immanuel. We give thanks for the offering of talent that Jennifer and Fred give, and Kim, and all those who help support worship.
Our offering song is Give Thanks.
Give thanks to the Lord.
Let's pray together, offering prayer. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. You have set before us these gifts of your good creation. Prepare us for your heavenly banquet. Nourish us with this rich food, drink, and send us forth to set table in the midst of a suffering world. Through the bread of life, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Our song of thanksgiving is Amazing Grace.
Especially on this Reformation Sunday, we give thanks for God's word, which is our ground and our guide. And as we are always reminded, the greatest gift after Christ himself. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. By your word, you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts, freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Send now your spirit of truth, O God. Rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love. For the sake of a world in need, faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you in the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. Now let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now receive the blessing. May Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you all now and forever.
Amen.
Our sending song is Mighty to Save.
Thanks be to God.